Hello, how are you doing? Dark Sage Ron here. Or I should be here. How are you doing behind the desk? Is it a little bit too dark? Can you see me? Cause I don't want to get up. I don't want to get up. I am comfortable. It was good. Except this morning. This morning I go to pay my natural gas bill. Find out my cash card is missing. Like, ah, Kubo, did I forget it at home? Well, go through the day. Go to the post office, the post office that I went to last night to mail something, and lo and behold, I actually forgot it there. Good, I got my postcard, my cash card again, and yeah. After that was about 4:30. That was about 4:30 and not 4. No, that was about 5 o'clock in the evening, and then I had a bunch of running around to do. In Japan, the post you have the post op, the Japan Post is not only a postage place. It's not only a post office. In Japan, it's actually also a bank. So you have Japan Post, which does the post. And then you have Japan Post Bank. And that's, yeah. So anyways. And then after I get back into Toriday, where I live. And then I have to go and pick up some forms. Put money on my train card and get pictures taken for tomorrow. That takes a while. Then I come back home, change out of my jacket and pants that I'm wearing, so I could rush take those into getting dry cleaned as. And then, yeah. By the time everything I had everything done, it was 7 o'clock, and yeah, I got home and had something to eat, and then watched The Flash about 8 o'clock, and without knowing it, I ended up taking a cat nap for about an hour, and that's why I'm yawning right now. Nope. I can't. I have to be able to wear a suit. I cannot wear jeans. No, actually, you get used to it. Oh, trust me, I know how you feel. It's, thank goodness I don't have to wear one in summer. But no, I mean, even if I was working at a language school itself, about regular time, if not a little bit later. Yeah, I'm taking the car to the train station, so. So, I mean, the latest I leave here is about 7:10. Can somebody not res me? About an hour and, well, I guess an hour and 10, hour and 20, I believe. It cost me about $15 one way. Yes, it will be. Now all I have to do is Void Arc! Gold Saucer, card deck... It changed. Not by much, but it changed. Oh, behind the desk, guess what? I could buy a VR set at my like local Walmart type store for $15 for my phone. You know, like the Google 3D thing where the Google Cardboard where you can make like a 3D viewer out of cardboard and then use your phone. I could buy one for $15, and that's not only all. That's not all. They have a 3D lens setup for your phone as well. So you attach this to your phone camera, and it captured it captures left and right angles, at like from pictures and video you can make. So I'm almost tempted to buy it. That costs like $5. So altogether for the whole setup, for like the 3D thing and then the lens attachments to make 3D movies or VR movies, altogether it's like $20. I think that might be an actual good price. But like I said, I'm thinking of if I get a PS4, I would probably definitely get Final Fantasy 14 for it, and then possibly getting the PlayStation VR to see what it would look like. Cause I would love to experience Eorzea like through 3D goggles. I mean, it would be awesome. I mean, there's so much beauty in here. Like, Square Enix really did a good job in Final Fantasy, in all honesty. With this, I mean, the views are just amazing. Imagine looking through a 3D glasses. I mean, at these buildings alone, that would be amazing. But to come to a place like this, go into first person mode and look around. Look at that view. Thank you. Hey Dave, how are you doing? That's good. That's good. I need the twine first. You know what? While I'm waiting, I might as well do. I've been putting it off. I really have been putting it off because I don't want to continue his quest line. Hearken to me, you dastardly rascallions. You have nowhere to run. Reveal yourself at once. I shall not ask you again. Come forth, grand sirs, name yourself, and answer for your misdeeds. Slayer of a thousand worms, the silver spear which hath pierced the very heavens, Orland! Master of magics, ancient and awesome, the divine hand which hath defeated the maladies, save sustenance and incontinence, Gonspart! Grand Sirs, Excelsior! I don't know whether to laugh or cry. Mayhap both. Grand Sirs, Grand Sirs, you stand accused of willfully and unlawfully convincing young maidens of Ishgard to attend private parties under false pretenses, thereby inflicting upon them terrible financial and emotional distress. I, Hildebrand, ancient of inquiry, inspector extraordinaire, have come on behalf of these poor, defenseless innocents, and to see that no others are made to suffer as they did. Now lay down your arms and surrender yourself into my custody. Ha! The audacity of this boy! You should feel ashamed of your words and deeds. You will rue this day, rue it hard. Gods, how I miss this! The air streaming past, the blood pumping, the taste of copper on my lips, the slight dizziness. It was on a day like that we met, wasn't it? And when we soared into those azure skies, we never truly came back down. Do my eyes deceive? Pygmy of my heart, descended from Harlan's halls to guide me to her bosom. My beloved, my everything, long have I waited for this moment. Take me in your arms once more and lift me higher, higher, higher. Higher, higher, higher! Orland! 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 How does that even happen? In all honesty, how does that even happen? Alas, poor Orland! I knew him not in the slightest, but he seems a decent man. Chicanery and attempted murder notwithstanding. You will rue this day and ruin it hard. Well, he's halfway buried. Wait, I've seen this before, all too recently. Ahem. Yes, anyways, he's only mostly dead. If it's Master of Magic, Ancient and Awesome here acts with all haste, the man may yet be saved. Oh, you're referring to me. I see. With all haste with it? Yes, I'll get right on that. Oh, mournful voice of creation, send unto me a creature of the abyss, my thrall to command, that I may smite. No, wait, that's no good. Let me see. Something of rather less controversial tradition, yes? Something with more pep, a vortex of biting winds to rend the flesh, as smite my foes. Foes? I thought you were friends. St. Renette bugging me with a bleeding gay blog. Me back. Gert, 'twas seem I've underestimated you lot. That makes two of us. Enough, leave them be. Or do you not care what becomes of the mammoth? Gigi, but when? How? I thought I recognized you. First in Ishgard, then in Idleshire. You've been following us since we left the capital. Fairer! Our face is fair and fearsome, the midnight shadow which has deceived kings and queens. Doris! You can't possibly have been so naive as to think we'd not see through your ridiculous disguises. And yet here you are, so effortlessly and easily lured into our trap. for which we are most grateful. Mind, my companions are hardly cut out for life on the road. All has been in preparation for this moment. The parties, the petty schemes, from the first, the objective of this grand design has been this singular mammoth. I swear to you, if you harm Gigi in any way, we have no desire to hurt the boy. We but require his help to reclaim that which is rightfully ours, our youth. Confound it! I can't see! Damn! They're very slowly getting away. Papa Hildy! Gigi! Stay strong, my son. I swear I shall find you. Why don't you go after him? This is why I don't like Hildebrand quests. Twelve strike me down for a fool. So desperate was I to seize the grand sirs that I failed to discern their true intent before it was too late. And now poor Gigi is in their clutches. What if I never see my beloved son again? I suppose we ought to prepare for the worst. They could be halfway to Rad's Aton by now. I very much doubt that, given that they were moving at an Adamantois's pace. The little milksop's right. Let's get after those old buggers. Huh? That's what my mentor used to call me, among other things, all the memories. There's a building at the very top of that thing. So it seems that the Grand Sirs have been caught once more by the very inspector that was trying to catch them. How ironic. Also, how premature. We have them, yes, but they still have Gigi. Damn it, if only some manner of opportunity were to present itself. Ask and you shall receive. We could ambush a wizened dragoon, taking him hostage and demand an exchange. Inquisitor Seer, you disappoint me. A gentleman cannot condone the violent kidnapping and ransom of his elders. No, we shall approach this problem as a paragon of honor and virtue. Sarah Linde will stalk and subdue the Grand Sir, then relieve him of his armor. How is stripping an old man naked more gentlemanly than taking him hostage? Rest assured, I shall reveal all soon enough. Godspeed, Sarah Linde. You and your stupid plans. And of course, there have to be Marlboros around. Run away from the Marlboros! Ah, son of a Koopa! Ah, I knew you'd... Wait, who are you again? There's something awfully familiar about those muscular forearms, those strong yet tender-looking fingers. I say, would you be so kind as to massage my shoulders, young lady? There's this lingering ache and the tension that Gonspark can't seem to soothe with his magics. Remove my breastplate? Oh, of course, how silly of me. Pray lend me my hand with the straps. Truly, young lady, you are a saint. Ah, I swear that little thing you began to appreciate, my dear departed wife, used to help me with my armor, you know? Right, I should be seated to better receive your tender ministrations. Ah, the healing tingle. Would that I had a tincture of salamander with which to treat these aches. My little pig's knee used to spread some on my chest under my nose to help me sleep through the night. Come, do not be shy. Work those soothing fingers into each and every knot slowly. Make me forget my troubles. Harder, hard, higher, higher. Close your eyes and dream. My stalwart assistant, by your return I gather you have taken care of the dragoon, and by taking care I mean afford him all due courtesy as befitting a man of his years, whilst returning with the equipment I required. Capital! And without further ado I shall disguise myself as Orland and free Gigi from captivity. But you two look nothing alike. They may be old and slow, but they're not blind. Oh, ye of little faith, you are in for a treat, for you shall have a front row seat to the magnificent display of Mandevillian guile and subterfuge. Hey, is it time for dinner yet? We just ate, you daft bugger. And where the hell is Orland? I know he got to take a pee every hour, but damn it, could he at least be quick about it? Greeting, fellow Antivillians, I have returned. Oh, bollocks. It's about time. Okay, no, that's bollocks. Pick up your things. I want us back on the road in 10 minutes. Before we do that, we must first release young Gigi here. Tis behavior unbecoming a gentleman to keep children in cages. What in the seven hells are you blathering about? He's going to get away! No, he will not. See? Still here with my care. Right then, on a completely unrelated note, I shall now take the boy with me on a brief sojourn into the wilderness. Fury, take me. It's working. He's about to walk out of there with Gigi, and they won't even try to stop him. So far, so good. Brr, I'm cold, and there are more burrows after me. I'm me, but you're also me, but that can't be unless... That is it. This is the moment when my life flashes before my eyes. Oh, my dearest Pigsney, we'll be together at last. Oh my, are these really dense? Imposter! How dare you attempt to trick me with a ruse so hackneyed? It would make a minstrel blush. Ye gods! I never realized dying would hurt so much. Now's our chance, Gigi. Come with me. Vivi! My son, what's gotten into you? I'm going to have to skip it. J10TV, how are you doing? Thank you very much for joining. after I'm done this dungeon, I'm going to go off the air for about 15-20 minutes, and then I'll be back. Oh, this guy, I hate this guy.
Thank you.
Okay, guys, I will be back in about 20 minutes. I will keep the stream on so it'll be easier to switch over. But yeah, I will be back in about 20 minutes. And guys, I am back. Thank you very much for your patience. Okay. My stalwart assistant. By your return, I gather you have taken care of the dragoon, and by taking, I mean afforded him, Duke. Everything, yes, everything. I remember that Grandpa Quan created me and that he took care of me, raised me, and that we were very happy. But then he abandoned me. Grandpa Quan abandoned me. He believed you were flawed, Vivi, that you lacked the power to turn back the hands of time and make him young again. And so, in his ignorance, he cast you out and died all alone. Turn back the hands of time. To turn back the hands of time. Then what we witnessed in Crozier with the Duke's priceless vase, the power could be brought to bear on people? But wait, how do you know all this? You couldn't have possibly been associates of the Archmage Quan. We found his journals in one of our many trips into the Great Library. Scavenging for valuable relics is one of the few ways we have left to make a living. We were famed heroes of the war in our prime, and fortunes to match. But no soldier has the strength to triumph over time, and before we knew it, the hour of the sheath was upon us. Ishgard no longer needed our service. So we came here to eke out a living, to keep doing what we do best until our bodies wouldn't let us. Imagine our surprise when we stumbled upon the opportunity of a lifetime, a second lifetime as it were. A mammoth with the power to take that which was broken and restore it to its prime state, to turn back time with its temporal magic and give us back our misspent youth. Fury, take me! This is also... I don't even know if there's a precedence to determine whether or not this constitutes heresy. We knew where to look, even. With the journals, we determined that the mammoth was somewhere in the Western Highlands. A chance for a second chance within our reach. And then we were forced to watch as you imbeciles pulled Vivi from the snow, nearly ruining everything. Vivi, listen to me. Come with us and we can help you unlock your true potential. Just think that what you could accomplish were you to master your magics. Not only could you make us young again, but you may even have the power to restore life of Archmage Quan. Vivi. Impossible. No magic can truly return the dead to us. At best, you can animate a corpse. And I need not review the precepts to declare that the products of necromancy are an abomination in the eyes of the Fury. Gigi, wait! What of our adventures? What of our gazebo? You are a Mandeville Mammoth. You have always been so kind to me, Papa Hildy, and I will forever be grateful for that. But Grandpa Quan made me. He made me, and I miss him. So even if it fails, I have to try. What are you doing? They're getting away. We have to stop them. Mayhaps. We must respect Gigi's decision. So that's the end of the chapter, eh? You're giving up and coming back home? I too made a decision long ago to become a traveling inspector, and I have ever stood by it. Mayhaps it is from a singular stubbornness of mine that Gigi took inspiration. Nay, I cannot abide it. He is my flesh and blood, my son. I dare not let him use his temporal magics to pervert the natural order. It falls to me, his father, to ensure that Gigi keeps to the righteous path and only utilizes traditional methods of zombification to raise the dead. Inquisitor Seer, I must applaud your dedication to your work. Everybody still there? Cool, just making sure. I cannot thank you enough for all that you have done on our behalf. Yet, I fear if we continue as we are, Gigi may be driven to rash actions. Therefore, I would ask that you suspend your pursuit of the Grand Sirs for a time, that I may be afforded the opportunity to convince my son to return peacefully. Well, seeing as how we could only guess at the full extent of Gigi's powers, it might prove dangerous to act aggressively should he choose to use them. I knew you would understand. Right then, there is no time to waste. Nashu, let us retire to our new gazebo and discuss our plans. I suppose I'd be in it. It'll be a shame to had he given up that easily, though that means I have to stick around even longer. On the other hand, if that bloody mammoth's really got the power to make them young again, then hee. I said I suspend my pursuit, and I will. But that doesn't mean I won't continue my investigation into that mammoth and its powers in Ishgard. Ah, I see you saw fit to return to the capital as well. The Inquisition has a rather large collection of heretical tomes, including many of Charlean origin, and I had a mind to scour them for information on temporal magics. This is, of course, all for the sake of confirming the mammoth's heretical origins. Yes, only that. Why are you looking at me like that? As if to imply that my interest in these matters is more than just professional one. I'm sure I don't know what you're not talking about. Thank you, Sarah Linde. That will be all. Just quickly checking something here. Okay, guys, I think I'm going to have to quit here. Okay, I'm going to thank you very much for watching. My name is Dark Sage Ron, the Relaxed Gamer. And like always, save now, save often. I will talk to you later. Bye.